Texas is a talk show. As usual, I am your host, Jordan Newman. I'm joined by Arjun, Jacob, and Miranda. Say hi, everyone. How are you doing?
Hello.
Hi. Doing pretty good.
Yay. Oh, so far, the mics are actually working. Yay. Arjun, does your mic work?
Does it?
Yeah, it does. Awesome.
I wouldn't be able to tell if it worked. That's your job.
It's a toss-up. Sure, well, I don't know. I couldn't hear if you were talking. It's kind of a toss-up around here. So let's see. We've got a... This is a very special... kind of nearly hour-long episode of The Eyes of Texas because the DJ after us can't make it, so we're subbing their show. And that's appropriate because we have four people and a lot to talk about this week in pop culture. We've got... Let's just start with the Star Wars trailer because that's fun. I guess if you're listening to this later, not that anyone would, but if you're listening to the recording of this later...
I used to listen to the recordings. You have some people.
Okay, there are some people who will be listening.
Just one person.
Me? For whoever's listening later on the recording, there will be timestamps in the description of the little YouTube video there that will explain where we're talking about which topics in case only part of this show interests you. If you're listening live...
Or none of the show.
Yeah, if none of the show interests you, you know...
You can just browse through and be like, well,
yeah,
I'll
you could
tune
just
in next
click
week.
On it and see what happens. Give me a view. If you're listening to this live in your car or something, you're kind of stuck with whatever we talk about unless you change the channel, I guess, but don't do that.
Mm-hmm. That sounds a little
desperate. I guess you just can't skip around is the gist I'm getting to here. So yeah, a lot happened this week in pop culture. We've got a new trailer for Star Wars Episode IX, The Rise of Skywalker. Does anyone want to give kind of random thoughts on the trailer so far?
Well, I saw the memes about it before I actually saw the trailer itself, so yeah. I was kind of confused at first. And then I saw the trailer, and I was still confused because I don't remember the last movie.
Oh, you don't remember what happened?
No,
oh.
Not really.
Yeah, that'll throw you off a bit. Yeah, I think it looks good. I'm excited for it.
You're excited for everything.
You know what?
You really can't say I'm excited for it because at this point, whatever you see, that's always the answer you're
that's
going
true.
To give.
You're not wrong.
If you see if you see a dog walking and then
dogs
all of
are
a sudden,
like, oh my god, a dog!
All of a sudden, it, like,
are you saying
oh, I'm not finished?
Be
I'm not. I'm not finished.
Okay.
I'm not finished. Can I finish?
Okay.
Can I finish?
Excuse me.
Anyways, if you see a dog walking and all of a sudden it takes like a number two, then you're gonna say, "Oh, I'm excited for that."
No, that's the one thing I am specifically not excited for after last weekend.
Oh yeah.
Oh man.
Mm. We had a little mishap in our apartment involving a dog. Last weekend.
Also, I did find out. I did find out that in Spy Kids 3, Dobby was featured in
yes,
the
yes, I saw that.
So every time people say Dobby sucks, we can just say, "Well, hey, was your apartment featured in a movie?"
You know, yeah, our apartment building, our
I don't
really
know if you
terrible
say
apartment
exactly
building.
Featured. It's in the background
was,
of like one.
If it's in the background,
if you zoom
featured.
And enhance,
it's featured.
We were featured. I think it's like a big
you
deal.
Have a point.
We, you know. Our you know, humble little home was in a movie at
humble?
Some point.
Mm-hmm.
Humble.
Would you really say it's
humble? I can honestly say that living there is a lesson in humility.
I mean, yeah. Having lived there last year myself,
it makes
not
me a
wrong.
Little humble.
You're definitely not
it makes,
wrong.
It makes me more humble to, like, appreciate the little things. Now
yeah,
because...
you appreciate the little things in life because your whole life is just kind of a mess.
Yeah, like literally in I mean, it feels mm-hmm. it's like
having floor other than just plain cement under your feet.
Oh, I love
oh,
that.
Man.
That
That's
is so great.
Great.
I always yell yeah. out lights out before I go to sleep because now it's, you know, prison.
Yeah, it's a prison. You keep coming back to the prison analogy. The
because
WWE.
It is.
You're not completely wrong. The food.
Oh my god.
Ask,
prison
ask
food.
Anybody who's lived there.
Oh god.
That's true.
I will never get over the pumpkin spice tilapia.
Oh
never.
Gosh.
Pumpkin spice
this is terrible.
Tilapia?
They
Why
had that,
that
last year, right around when fall started, and it was just the most disgusting thing I have ever eaten.
Terrible.
Now, they have had good things. Like, they had a chocolate mint cheesecake once that was to die for after,
okay.
like, three slices.
Okay, we're like, I'm gonna give it some credit. Like, on,
credit.
On, I forgot what day it was, but they had a pizza day.
Oh.
And it was
the
just.
The make your own pizzas?
Yes.
Oh my God. That was amazing.
Whenever they
that
do that,
was amazing.
I'm impressed.
Like, I need to text that number they give and be like, yo, you need to have more of that.
Just do that every day, three times a day.
I want pizza. Yeah.
But that's like, all we want.
The majority of the time, the rest of the food was so gross, I just made my own grilled cheese on the panini.
Oh my goodness. Yeah,
yeah, man. I've done that.
I just lost count of how many
grilled cheeses I had.
I just make grilled cheeses in my room.
Mm-hmm. I know. Yeah, yours are better than the ones we make there, but I didn't have my own induction plate.
Well, and the reason I never go down there is because the elevators barely work.
Oh my God.
We're on the 24th floor. Up on the 24th floor.
5 years to get there. That's why I'm always late to class.
Yeah.
Like, I got to write like a letter to my professors being like, yo, this is why I'm late.
Because I live in Dobie.
And once they see that, they're going to be like, oh, crap, yeah.
Oh, man,
One time, I had two exams last year on the same day, and that was the day that the power was out and the water was out.
Oh my God. It was
a hellish day because I woke up and it was so freaking hot in my room. I wanted to die.
Speaking of being hot, they came to fix the AC.
Oh wow!
Now it actually blows air.
It works
instead of it just making loud noises and nothing coming out. It blows air now.
So it's not just a white
crazy
noise
concept.
Machine
yeah.
anymore.
It's
That's
not just
fantastic.
A white noise machine. It blows air.
What a crazy concept! Whatever will they think of next?
Let's see if they put carpet.
Oh man,
couldn't. That's a stretch.
I don't think you would have wanted carpet last week though.
I wouldn't have. I would have.
That would have made that
man.
Much. Worse.
I would have like. No.
Thank God.
In this one circumstance.
Oh.
I'm glad for
we dodged a bullet having a concrete apartment.
I guess you can say it was a concrete idea.
I'm dumb.
that was so bad. Even
tile or wood would have just been horrible last week.
Yeah,
okay,
wood
would have been
the
fine. Wood would have been fine. They have Lemon Pledge.
Yeah,
but you have the grooves in between, and it would have seeped down in between. Oh. Like, maybe if you'd had linoleum.
Yeah.
Aluminium.
This just then, I'm the only one who knows
the aluminium. The aluminium crutch.
Malamium falcon.
The aluminum falcon.
And that's a lovely segue
favorite.
Back into Star
and that
Wars.
Was the, this is officially the longest intro for a Star Wars segment ever.
Oh, we're still talking about Star Wars?
We didn't talk about it yet.
You brought it back up.
I thought we were talking about apartments.
Yeah, you brought back up Star Wars.
Featured in Spy Kids 3. Game over.
You brought up the aluminum falcon, so now we're talking about the aluminum falcon.
well, I mean, I've built an aluminum falcon.
The melanoman falcon.
What? Stop trying to.
I think you mean Millennium Falcon.
The Millennial Falcon.
All of the Millennial.
The Millennial Falcon is
the Gen
just
Z
a,
Falcon.
Is just a flying Starbucks.
Mm-hmm. And of course, it's millennial paint.
That's the Gen Z Falcon. It's a flying Starbucks.
What is the Millennial Falcon?
It has to be millennial.
The Millennial Falcon is a
that's
boombox.
Soft.
The Millennial Falcon.
They can't afford the.
Is basically a thrift store. A flying thrift store.
In outer space.
I want that in. Come on, J.J. Abrams, put that in episode 9. I want the Millennial Falcon.
Flying, and then it's a thrift store in space, and they're like, oh, well, I mean, okay. You know, I've never seen like currency discussed in Star Wars. Do they just
currency
for
like
free?
Units.
That's so lame.
Yeah, Republic. No, it's credits. It's credits. Units is in like Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Republic credits. They've got Republic credits.
What if you have Empire credits?
So it seems like I have no idea what currency the Empire actually used, but it seems like before the Empire you have Republic credits and then you have like just barter systems.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not part of the Republic.
Sounds like a mess.
That Ray gets.
Yeah.
Sounds like a mess.
Yeah, and then in like the post Empire and everything, you see like a lot of planets where people get paid for things in portions of food that it's literally just you either have food or you don't have food, and food is the only currency.
Okay, I'm down.
Like Jakku.
food is the only currency.
Let's just get rid of U.S. dollars
and
food our currency.
Yeah, I'll charge you three Taco Bell boxes for that.
I'll buy this game with like three large fries from McDonald's.
Taco Bell ripped me off last night.
Dude.
I'm mad.
Yeah. I can't believe they did that to you.
I can't believe. Yeah. Oh yeah. Did you put it in the fridge?
Yeah, I did.
Good.
I know. I forgot too.
Yeah, we went there, and they failed to mention that they were out of lettuce and tomato.
Okay, I don't think they were out of lettuce or tomato. I think they were just too lazy to put it in.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm going to give them the benefit of the doubt and say they were out of lettuce and tomato and just didn't mention that.
No, you can't do that.
I can't give them the benefit of the doubt?
No.
Okay, cool. Then it's complete.
I've never been to Taco Bell.
Regardless,
I've never.
No, I've never been.
All three of our favorite fast food restaurants.
Yeah. I'll have to go sometime.
Not right now.
Okay, not for you, but.
Not right now.
My quesadilla doesn't have lettuce or tomato in it. It's just got meat and cheese and a tortilla.
I love getting from the Dollar Cravings menu because you get so much more food than the $5 box.
That's true. That's true. I love the dollar menu at Taco Bell.
Triple layer nacho.
We are now entering the ASMR feature.
Stop. Stop. Right now. Before I go across this table and smack you in the face.
You wanna fight
he
me,
will.
Sean.
He will do it. Okay. It's... oh, there he goes. Going. There he goes. No. He's on his way.
It's a match down.
That's what he just... the pain. We could turn this into we'll create radio cereals starting next week.
Radio cereals?
Yeah, radio cereals.
How are we gonna make cereal out of this?
What?
What is it gonna be? KVRX cereal?
No, you don't. You know, like cereals, like the '40s, like cereal, like storytelling cereals, like a show, like a radio cereal. Like we'll be like superheroes in the show, and we just make sound effects of what's going on. And so the audience uses their imagination to picture some epic adventure.
Okay, normally when people say cereal, I'm thinking of breakfast.
No, it's cereal just with an S. Common. With an S, it is not an like serial killer.
Well, then be...
What?
That kind of cereal.
That's well, actually the same word.
Be more specific next time.
Be more Pacific, not Atlantic, more you fool.
Yeah, don't be Mediterranean, be Pacific.
Gosh. Where were we? Where were we? Millennial Falcon.
Oh, yeah.
That's where we were.
Millennial Falcon. Jinx.
Oh, wow. That was about that. We do not do jinxes in this house.
We're not in a house.
You know, you make a compelling argument.
We have a roof over our heads.
But we're not in a house, though.
So Star Wars. So Star Wars is a thing. and it's... It looks good. It looks good. I think it's great. Billy Dee Williams is coming back, you know? Yeah.
Are we going to have to send you to your room?
I will turn your mic off.
Are we going to have to send you to your room?
Okay, I'm not a child.
If you're going to act like a child.
I'm not a child.
Then stop mimicking Jordan.
Are you sure?
I will go over this table.
I swear to gosh, I will fake smack you again. yeah.
But back to Star Wars.
I think it looks great. That's my assessment.
They're just making it. By
okay,
now.
It's really cool right. That we see Rey with the lightsaber again.
Yeah she's clearly so getting into some analysis.
Did she even use? She did use the lightsaber in Episode 8
briefly, and then it broke. So she's rebuilt it. So we know that she's now powerful enough to build a lightsaber because she's rebuilt.
She was just a useless character.
The other Rey?
Yeah.
Oh.
What?
In episode 8.
Like
she saved everyone.
Probably like not popular opinion, but
she saved everyone at the end of the movie.
Through Rey, we get a better understanding of what the Force is like.
No, she's just a useless character. Like I don't understand why they had to add her character into the world. I don't
because she's the main character.
But I mean, I don't get it. Like,
and also she's a badass female protagonist. The world needs more of those.
Of course, yes, I agree on that. But like, if you're gonna have a female protagonist, at least give them a story that they can build on.
Yeah, that is a valid complaint. That is, there's a lot of complaints about both the Force Awakens and The Last Jedi, and one of the valid complaints that I have to agree with, unfortunately, is that she doesn't have an arc. It's really just she's good at stuff, and she gradually gets even better at stuff.
Yeah.
And there's really no... Like, they kind of did a little bit in The Last Jedi, where she's tempted by the dark area of the island, and then she's kind of got this weird, you know, Force DMs with Kylo Ren.
Force DMs?
Yeah, they slide into each other's... Slide into each other's Force DMs.
Mm-hmm.
And, stop. You need to stop
and that's exactly what it is.
No, it is.
And,
okay, okay.
So that was a story.
That wasn't a story. That was like a segment.
Yeah.
There's
not much of a journey
to the
character.
Can we all agree that Kylo Ren looked like a Roblox character?
Yes.
When he was shirtless in episode
I was very confused by that.
So wide.
He just turned around, and all I heard was, ooh!
He's a rectangle.
Whenever he got hit, all I heard was, ooh!
Yeah, Kylo Ren is just a... Yeah,
that was
just so wide. Dude swole.
He swole.
Yeah, it looks like he's rebuilt his helmet in the trailer. That's cool. He's soldered it back together.
He's gonna be all whatever. I want to be evil again, and then all of a sudden he's gonna switch to the force. And then
I hope not.
Blah blah blah.
I hope not. I hope
that's gonna be the biggest cliche, but I know they're going to.
I really hope not, because I want this to be like the mirror of Return of the Jedi, but in opposite. We're expecting to see him have this redemption arc like Vader, and then he doesn't, and then someone has to kill him.
Well, I almost wonder if it's going to be like a reverse Anakin and Padme, because it seemed like they were trying to build some sort of sexual tension between him and Rey. So maybe instead of like how Anakin became evil in order to try to preserve his connection with Padme, it'll be the other way around. Although that would be really awkward if she does somehow turned out to be related.
And that's what I was about to say. Imagine they're like siblings. And
yeah, because we don't know anything about her backstory aside from Kylo Ren / Ben Solo said, but we don't know whether or not that was truthful or whether he's just trying to manipulate her.
That's an interesting thought that I've heard before.
Is that a water speaker?
What?
That thing there. What? He's just now noticing.
I have absolutely no idea what that is. You just said it to me. Just casually mentioned something that the audience could never possibly know about as they listen on their radio.
Can I finish?
You're not even talking into the mic. I can't even hear you through the headphones.
Can I finish?
Yes.
You can finish talking about Star Wars.
Look, Miranda. what
else was in the trailer? Carrie Fisher's in the trailer.
Mm-hmm. Aww, yeah, there was a very tender moment
I'm guessing
Leia
it's like CGI. Yeah, Carrie Fisher? CGI.
Everything's CGI now.
Probably.
I hope they don't do much of that.
It is CGI because they did that with Rogue One.
Yeah, they did. And I hope they don't do much of it because I feel like that would be
Fast 8 was CGI.
Yeah. But I hope they don't do too much CGI Leia. I hope it's just long enough to kind of write her out of the story without killing off the character. Because I don't think you can like just keep going with the CGI Leia and have people not really freak out about it.
I freaked out about Rogue One CGI.
Yeah, but I feel like if they use it just enough to write her out of the story without killing her, I'm cool with it. Because you have to do something.
I mean, it would be easy to kill her.
I was about to say.
It would also
progress the plot, too.
But I feel like you almost can't.
But you can.
When the actress fairly recently died.
I feel like insensitive.
I feel like killing the character.
Technically, the actor in Rogue One, there was an actor who was CGI'd as well. I forgot his name, but he played one of the generals.
Yeah,
he died in Rogue One.
He didn't die in Rogue One.
Well, I mean, technically he did because the Death Star blows up eventually.
So. Yeah, so he dies in A New Hope.
But it doesn't matter. So he still died.
The actor's name, I believe, is Peter Cushing, playing Grand Moff Tarkin.
There we go.
And that was... I feel like it's a little different because the actor's been dead for a very long time.
That's offensive.
And the movie doesn't portray the death of his CGI counterpart. And I feel like that would be... I feel like they can't do that. I would be upset if they did that.
Yeah, that's still too soon.
What are you doing?
I thought you were against ASMR.
What are you...
I just know you can hear everything that's happening.
Okay, well, now I can't. Oh! You forget I am at the controls. Death stare. I like it. You're turned up, by the way. You can still, like, I'm not... muting
you.
Okay, cool. Just making sure you knew I didn't actually mute you. Let's see. What else happened? Billy Dee Williams is back. I'm excited. I like it. He looks good for his age. He's getting pretty old. I don't know how old he is, but I think he's 80s? Probably? I'm pretty sure he's in his 80s, and I think he looks pretty good for that. I hope they don't kill him, because they've killed everyone else.
Mm-hmm.
I really don't want Lando to die. Speaking of Lando, I loved Donald Glover's portrayal of Lando in
Solo.
I thought it was
so good.
That was the best part of the movie.
It was so good.
It would be really interesting if Kira makes an appearance too. Now Kira, that she's been
from Solo, yeah. I wonder how you'd do that.
I don't know.
You'd have to. I don't. I feel like not enough people would have watched Solo.
Yeah.
That if you brought Kira back into like one of the current, like present day films, like 40 years in the future, I don't think enough people would know who she is to make that work.
But so it'd be cool to have a female villain because I don't think we've had that in Star Wars, have we?
We had Captain Phasma.
We had Captain Phasma.
She just had like maybe 10 lines total.
What I love about that is that she was supposed to be some big deal. Like everyone was talking about the actress being cast, and it's like, oh, this is awesome. She's going to be like this epically badass character. And she had maybe 4 lines in episode 7, and then just dies lame. In episode 8.
I'm just upset with how Snoke died. I was expecting a bigger battle.
I also just want more information about him. What's the deal?
Yeah. Where'd he come from?
Maybe he's a reincarnation of Emperor Palpatine.
Maybe. And we do hear Emperor Palpatine's laugh in the trailer for episode 9. How do you think that's... Do you think he's coming back to life?
He can't.
You don't think he's going to come back to life?
He can't. He's dead.
You never know. Is he dead?
That's just saying, can Anakin come back to life?
He's
probably doing the ghost thing.
He can't.
Yeah, he might be doing the ghost thing.
Why can't he?
There's some lore.
You cannot become a ghost in the Star Wars universe unless you have a connection with the Force, and Emperor Palpatine did not have a connection with the Force.
Okay.
So he can't be a ghost. Which is why when Anakin died in episode 6, he came back as a ghost later on, because he found that connection within the Force.
Yeah.
Because he forgave himself because of Luke.
Which makes
me question. We've never seen Qui-Gon as a ghost. So
you see him as a ghost in Star Wars: The Clone Wars in the TV show.
Ah, that's right. I've never seen the TV show.
Yeah, the TV shows are canon.
Okay, interesting.
They are
interesting.
Which is I was talking to Jacob earlier about how anyone who didn't watch the TV shows would have just been really heckin' confused when Darth Maul abruptly shows up at the end of Solo. It's like, wait, what?
I was confused
because I never seen that.
And like, because if you watch the TV shows, you know, you find out that he's still alive, and then there's this whole arc with him in the Clone Wars, and it involves him basically taking over some crime families. And so it's like, then we run into him in Solo, having taken over some of the crime families. I'm like, oh, that's exactly where I expected to find him. So I wasn't phased at all. I was surprised that they put him in a live action thing, but I was not at all surprised that he was around. I like the TV shows. I think they're done well.
Yeah.
By the way, in Rebels, there's like some... I haven't actually watched Rebels all the way through, but I know there's some story arc that has to do with minor time travel, basically, where they find some place that's like the nexus of all everything, and like you can see moments from the past and the present and the future, and Palpatine's like trying to figure out how to use that.
Okay.
Maybe.
Also,
he time traveled into the future.
Okay. Also, there's a new Star Wars game coming out too.
What is that? It's called
Star Wars Jedi: The Last Order.
It's a single player campaign by EA.
Yeah,
microtransactions.
I mean, it's by EA, so I'm a little skeptic. Yeah. But it takes place after Order 66. One of the people from Order 66 survived, and they become a Jedi.
That's fascinating. I really like. That's cool.
Yeah,
that sounds fun, and it's canon.
I think it's canon. It should be because it takes place right after Episode 3, so it should be canon.
That's very cool. That's a part of the world I want to see.
I hope it's open world. I hope it's free roam where you could just roam around.
When's it coming out?
In November of this year.
Okay, that's not too far. I'm excited. That seems good.
And it'll be around a month before episode 9.
Yeah, they're going to release it like a month before episode 9.
Intriguing.
So
like, yeah.
But I'm a little skeptic because I'm barely finding out about this. I don't know how long they've been working on it. I don't know how long.
That's kind of a good point.
They flopped us with Battlefront and Battlefront 2.
Oh, Battlefront 2 wasn't good?
Heck no.
Oh, that's sad. I got Battlefront and didn't enjoy it, and then I didn't get Battlefront 2.
The only thing I liked about Battlefront 2 was that they took away the microtransactions.
That's good.
And
after a while,
and then you don't have to buy anything to unlock characters. You just have to keep playing.
Those are good things.
And they brought back Heroes versus Villains. If you played the original Battlefront on the PSP or on the PlayStation 2, they brought that back.
That's fun. I like that. So what made it? What made Battlefront 2 disappointing?
It kind of follows the same as Battlefront.
Okay.
Like it's the like they're still just multiplayer. They tried to implement single player, but it didn't work.
Yeah,
out
that's
that well.
I wanted like a story that you could play maybe.
Me too.
Mm-hmm. By yourself, just in case.
Yeah, the new game is just going to be a single-player story.
That's exciting.
Because
like
with
that.
Battlefront 2, they tried to implement a single-player story that takes place after the New Hope.
Hmm.
Or the New Hope. After a New Hope.
The New Hope.
It takes place after a New Hope when after the Death Star is being planned to blow up.
Mm-hmm.
That's when Battlefront 2's story takes place.
Okay, that's cool. Yeah, they've also got... there's been a whole bunch of announcements lately about the Disney Plus streaming service that's going to come out soon. That sounds very interesting because I think the number is $7 a month so far.
Seven for what?
For the Disney streaming service. And
really?
I think that's worth it.
Are they going to bring back Daredevil? Because if not, I'm not interested.
I don't know. I don't think so.
They should,
not,
okay,
for at least 2 years, they can't.
I'm so mad.
I know they can't for 2 years, but after
so
that,
mad.
Maybe. But I know
so
they
mad.
Are doing...
I am so mad.
I know you are.
You gotta ask why, or else I'm gonna keep saying
oh,
it.
Oh, go ahead. Why are you
because
so mad?
Because they shouldn't have canceled Daredevil. Like, that was such a good show.
I do think it's... I think it's studio politics. I do. I don't think Netflix canceled it because they didn't want to keep doing it. I think it was
Well, I know
politics.
They didn't cancel it because of that. I know they canceled it because of Disney.
Yeah. Sometimes Disney hurts us. But yeah, so they're doing a live-action TV show called The Mandalorian,
oh my God.
Which will be have like nothing to do with anything you've ever seen before in Star Wars. It's a completely separate story about a Mandalorian who's just like his own thing. I think that's interesting. It's going to be set somewhere in the Star Wars universe, and they're also doing a season 7 of The Clone Wars, the final season. They're finally giving it a really good ending.
Clone Wars is still going on?
No, it ended, I want to say... 4 or 5 years ago with a limited season 6 that was direct to Netflix, but it was because the show didn't have the ratings to get its like planned ending, and now there's enough of kind of a cult following around it that they're bringing it back for Disney Plus for that original planned ending with a season 7. I'm like, thank God, I've been waiting for this.
You know, I'm waiting for Teen Titans season 6.
Oh yeah, is that a thing?
No.
Oh.
But
well,
I'm waiting.
Well,
okay, actually, there's a rumor going around that when the Teen Titans Go movie came out,
mm-hmm.
the one that came to the theaters, if they got a lot of money out of it, that would be used to budget season 6 of Teen Titans.
Okay.
But it was just a rumor. I don't know if that's actually real. Because
that
movie came out, like, last year, I think?
Yeah, Teen Titans Go?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that was last year.
They got their own movie, and... Because even in Teen Titans Go, they even bash on their own show. Like,
yes.
It's super meta.
Teen
that's,
Titans
I,
Go,
I like that about the show.
Teen Titans Go has a lot of really fun stuff in it. And they had a Stan Lee cameo, which is hilarious that they put a Stan Lee cameo in Teen Titans Go.
Also, they went back to the Batman series, the animated series.
Yeah, they had a reference
to
the
and
Batman.
They got Kevin Conroy to do Batman's voice.
Yeah. That's cool. I like that. What was I just had something on the top of my head. Oh yeah, with the Disney Plus streaming service, they're also doing a Falcon and Winter Soldier TV series that's gonna be kind of Netflix style ish where it gets released. And it's gonna be actually Anthony Mackie and Sebastian Stan, and it's just gonna be a story about Falcon and Winter Soldier, presumably after Endgame. When,
so,
I want
speaking
that.
Of Endgame.
Speaking of Endgame.
Who's, who's going to become the new Captain America? Falcon or
I don't
Bucky?
Think either of them will.
They have to.
Wait, is there going
to
be a new one? Or?
I don't
what?
Think either of them will
they
take on the mantle. I don't think so.
They have to.
You may want them to.
No, it's not that I want them to. Is that
why
they have
do they,
to.
Why do they have to?
Because it happens in the comics.
But have they done everything from the comics?
Yes. Infinity War followed the comics very well.
But Civil War did not.
Yes, it did.
Besides
most of the characters that did that fought
and,
in the Civil War
Cap
that weren't
didn't
there.
Die in the Civil War. In the comics, he does.
What?
He dies right after the Civil War in the comics. He's assassinated.
He also dies in Infinity War too. He comes back and he dies in Infinity War.
Yeah, but they haven't killed him in Civil War.
But they're gonna kill him in Infinity War.
So this doesn't mean they have to track everything from the comics.
But he's going to die in Infinity. And he's going to die in Endgame.
He probably will. But that doesn't
someone has to take up the mantle. Falcon or Bucky.
But if they're coming out with a Winter Soldier and Falcon TV show, it'd be weird of them for one of them to suddenly become Captain America.
Yeah. Maybe that's why they're coming up with the TV show.
But wouldn't they change the name?
No.
So you're thinking throughout the course of the TV show, one of them eventually decides to just become the next Captain America?
Yeah.
Doesn't that require the Falcon maybe serum? Or Bucky. Do they still have that?
Maybe. Well, I mean, Bucky's like as enhanced as Cap.
Cap. Yeah.
So they're about on par for that. And I do think they're the big passing the torch moment, in my theory, is going to be Captain America, you know, clearly acting as the leader of the Avengers, kind of passing on, because no one has called Captain Marvel Captain Marvel yet. When we saw Captain Marvel, I haven't seen it.
So.
No one mentions that name. Yeah. Like they mentioned that the person who indirectly gave her powers was named Marvel, but
Fury
no one
calls
ever
her Marvel.
Yeah, Fury mispronounces it Marvel on purpose because he says Marvel sounds better, but no one ever actually says the words Captain Marvel in the movie. So I think that's gonna get established in Endgame, of like, you know, Cap is gone, and then it's like the name of Captain just kind of
Iron Man and Captain America are both dying in Endgame. That's already a given.
Maybe.
No, both. No, it's not a maybe.
I don't know.
Their
about
contracts
Iron Man.
Are ending. Yeah, they have to what kill
if
them all.
What if they retire?
They're not going to retire. They're going to die.
I think
Endgame.
One of them will die and one of them will retire.
No,
that's
both
of them
are going to die. They already hinted at Iron Man trying to retire when they took out the arc reactor out of his chest.
Yeah.
To live peacefully with Pepper. And you already know that Pepper wants him to stop doing the Iron Man thing.
Yeah, he's definitely been trying to retire for a very long time.
And he has proposed, and like clearly this distance, like it's very clear how important Pepper is to him. Yeah. So he could step down to live a quiet life with her.
But, but he's going to have to fight Thanos either way.
He will, but that could be the thing that makes him decide to step down from the mantle.
That's if he survives.
If he survives, yes.
Because both of them, like, I already know Chris Evans and Robert Downey Jr.'s contracts are ending after Endgame.
Yes.
So either both of them are going to die, or one's going to retire and one's going to die. I know Cap is going to die for sure.
I'm betting Iron Man retires.
Mm-hmm. What about Gwyneth Paltrow's contract? Do we see her again?
I have no idea.
Yeah, I have no idea either.
Because
if they both have their contracts end, then they could live off in a happy mansion in the hills.
True. I think Hemsworth's contract is also...
I think he has another year with Marvel before his contract expires.
Year? I think they measure them in movies, not years.
No, they measure them in...
I'm pretty sure it's in movies, because I remember that the whole deal was that Chris Evans had a 6-film contract. I think they measure TV actors in years.
Because the seasons are more reliable.
Yeah, because I remember that Stephen Amell was under contract to play Oliver Queen through 2019.
don't mind me.
Exactly. There's another little pop culture thing to mention is Arrow is coming to an end, beloved by many comic book fans. The show Arrow will be ending after a 10-episode run this fall of 2019, and then it will be gone. Arrow will be gone, and that's sad. I'm sad. I really like Arrow. Although it feels like it's kind of come to a natural conclusion, I'm not all that sad because I'm excited to see how the story is going to play out here at the end.
Yeah, me too.
It seems like it's going to be at least really exciting as it comes to a close, because we're getting the Crisis. This fall, we are getting the Crisis on Infinite Earths on the CW superhero TV shows. I'm very excited.
They better not butcher it.
They better not. It's one of the most famous comic
Crisis
book stories
on Earth
of all
X
time.
Was the worst crossover ever.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah, probably. Wait, what came after that? Was that Elseworlds? Elseworlds was great.
Elseworlds was great. Yeah.
I loved Elseworlds. Yeah. That's...
But Crisis on Earth X was just horrible.
Yeah, it was. I didn't remember being particularly disappointed by it. It may have been a little too long. It was 4 episodes.
I'm really excited for Crisis on Infinite Earth stuff.
Like, yeah, I hope
I've been calling that since 2014.
Yeah, I hope they nail it. Yeah, as soon as, like, literally the pilot episode of The Flash at the end, you're just like, they're going to do
Once I saw that newspaper article saying Red Skies, I was like, yep, crisis.
And then Grant Gustin confirmed that eventually they were going to go for the crisis. And I was
you better not ruin it, though.
I'm excited. There's your DC TV rant for the day. Does anyone still watch them? I feel like
I'm pretty sure.
I feel like we're
seen them
and you
yet.
And you're like 8 episodes behind now, and otherwise
I know it's because like I wait for it to be over so I can just binge without waiting.
Well, you didn't used to, and it makes me sad.
Yes, I did. I've always done
that. No, you didn't. We watched the entire first half of the season.
Yeah, but then I got tired of waiting week after week.
So you didn't used to.
Yes, I did. Literally with every TV show I've done that.
But not these
But there's
ones.
Been a time when you haven't done that. Yes. And that's what he's referring to. He misses that you don't do that anymore.
Do you have to step in for everything?
Well, someone has to
be... The man can talk for himself.
But yeah, you're now like 8 episodes behind on those. And other than you, I'm the only person I'm aware of who actually watches these shows. So I'm like, I've got so much to vent and no one to say it to. But oh well.
Have you been keeping up?
Yeah. I'm still caught up. I'm waiting. They took like 4 weeks off abruptly, and it made me sad. But I think they're coming back this next week, maybe? Maybe? Also, Gotham is about to end.
Good.
I think they come back this week, maybe next week, and then there's 2 more episodes and they're gone.
Have they shown him in the Batman suit yet?
I told you, that's going to be the last episode.
It's not.
It's going
to
be the
he's
last.
He's going to leave Gotham
nope,
in the last episode.
It's going to be the last episode.
No, he's going to leave Gotham.
We're
going to
see.
He's going
the
to
The last
leave.
Episode will be 10 years
no,
in the future,
it, no,
and he's
going
to be in the Batsuit.
He's going to leave on the last episode.
Not yet.
He's going to leave
we'll
Gotham.
Find out. We'll
he's
find
going
out
to leave
right.
Gotham to go train.
All right, I'm going to come back on this show and update everyone on who was right, because it's going to be me.
Mm-hmm. Put it in the event description. Not event. The video description. For when you upload it to YouTube. You can tell them, hey, guess what? I was right. Arjan was wrong.
Yeah.
Ha!
And I will. Mm-hmm. That's exactly what I'm going to do.
Those words exactly?
Yes.
Nice.
Okay. I'm trying to adjust some settings over here so that I don't create some weird audio feedback on the Audacity. Okay. We've had trouble with recording audio lately. where were we? What were we talking about? Endgame, Disney Plus. There's also supposedly going to be a Vision and Scarlet Witch show.
Really?
On
That'll
Disney
be
Plus.
So cute.
Yeah, I want it to just be like a rom-com.
Yeah.
just a fun
I would
little
love
show.
That.
Never mind. I was going to say
what?
Vision died, but then they're all going to come back.
Yeah, they'll Witch, probably.
They'll
so
back.
Let's be real. Yeah. Everyone's coming back.
Yeah. One thing I kind of don't like, though, is that, like, because Endgame is supposed to be, like, the whole end to, like, this whole big universe thing.
The Infinity Saga,
yeah.
As Kevin Feige puts it.
And then 2 months later, they're coming out with a new Spider-Man movie. I feel like I feel like there should be more of a break, just so that people can, like, sit and, like, take it all.
I don't know. I like that they're doing it.
Maybe the Avengers will break up and everyone just does their own thing.
Maybe. That would be interesting.
That could explain why there's so many spin-off TV shows. It's just, like...
Maybe.
Got the rom-com thing with Scarlet Witch and Vision.
Perhaps.
And then you've maybe got like a buddy cop type thing with Falcon and Winter Soldier.
Yeah, perhaps whatever happens to Cap and Iron Man causes the Avengers to just kind of split, fractures the group.
And then eventually you've got the band coming back together later.
For Avengers 5.
Mm-hmm.
Avengers versus X-Men. Avengers versus Deadpool.
Oh my God.
Just Deadpool.
Just Deadpool. But the good Deadpool, not the stitched up mouth.
Yeah.
Deadpool.
Oh, wouldn't that be great? Is the Avengers versus the Deadpool from X-Men Origins Wolverine? That would be exciting. I really want Deadpool to meet some Avengers eventually.
That would be awesome.
I need that. It can happen now,
mm-hmm.
and I need to see it.
Mm-hmm.
Marvel is... What I love is that Kevin Feige kind of recently announced that they've got plans for 20 more films.
Oh, my
God. Oh, man.
He was like, yeah, we've got 20 films in development, just ready to go. And that was before they had any confirmation that the Fox deal was going to go through.
Oh, man.
So I'm like, man,
oh
they just... they never have to end. They'll never run out of characters or stories now. They had 20 films in development before they knew they had the X-Men and the Fantastic Four. So, how do you think if they ever get around to rebooting the Fantastic Four? Do you think it's going to be...
Hey, third time's the charm.
Are you going to want them to do it, or are you going to want them to leave the Fantastic Four alone?
Just leave them alone.
If they do that, they need to reference the fact that Chris Evans played Human Torch in the first live action.
They need to. That would be great. I want them. I think I trust Marvel. I trust Marvel Studios. I think if they actually do reboot the Fantastic Four, it'll be a really good reboot of the Fantastic Four.
I like the last one.
I kind of want that. I'm excited. There's a lot going on. There's a lot of possibilities. Lucasfilm announced that they're kind of taking a step back after Episode 9, that there won't be anything for a while, supposedly. I think they're taking a couple years to figure out what they want to do, because they originally had all these different anthology films planned out, and then like a whole extra trilogy, and then mixed responses to the recent movies and the underperformance at the box office of Solo kind of scared them a little. And now it's not clear what they're going to do next. And I'm really scared that Star Wars is going to become the next DC, and I don't want that to happen. I really don't want that to
happen.
It's
kind of already there, so.
You're kind of right. That's the sad part, is it's kind of happened.
They're milking Star Wars at this point.
That they've sort of given up. They should have just. They don't really know what they're doing.
They should have just not even made Episode 7, 8, or not even make 9.
Probably.
They should have just kept it with Return of the Jedi.
Probably.
No, not
probably.
You know I'm right.
Well, I mean, yeah, it's, you know, there was, yeah, if you hadn't made them, I don't know. I feel like there's still people who appreciate the whole story for what it is. I know that I'm one of those people. Because I don't really dislike The Last Jedi. I just think there's a couple of really stupid decisions in terms of storytelling in The Last Jedi. And overall, I think that the story they're telling is a good story. So I am excited for Episode 9. I'm excited to see how it ends. And I wonder if this will be the end of Star Wars on the big screen for, like, a substantial period of time. Because they don't have any plans. So they might just not do any more, maybe. I kind of hope not, because I like Star Wars. I don't know about you, I like Star Wars.
I never said I didn't.
I don't know. I'm just saying. I want more Star Wars. I'm sad.
Well, I don't, because like as much as I love it, some things should just be kept in the past.
Yeah, probably.
Like literally 4, 5, and 6 were good. Mm-hmm. 1, 2, and 3 were all right. But they should have just ended it right there. Like after they made the prequel trilogy, they should have just stopped right there.
Well, but then because I think 7 is great, and I think Rogue One is great. I think Solo is severely underrated and a lot of fun.
I love Solo.
I thought it was great.
I saw it last night for the first time.
Yeah.
Excellent.
I thought The Last Jedi just had a couple of really dumb storytelling decisions.
Yeah.
But otherwise, I enjoyed the story of it. Like, the things that people tend to complain about The Last Jedi, I don't really get. There's a few. But I don't know. I'm kind of looking forward to this being a complete story. I'm hoping that Episode 9 can kind of smooth out some of the stuff that went wrong with Episode 8. Mm-hmm. I think it can. I have faith in J.J. Abrams as a director. Mm-hmm. That's the gist of that. What do you think the title means? The Rise of Skywalker? You think it's going to refer to
The Rise of Skywalker.
The Rise of Skywalker?
I mean, it has to do with the Skywalker. Apparently. We don't know who.
Apparently. We don't know who's rising.
Maybe Rey's a Skywalker, maybe... Mm-hmm. I mean, we already know Kylo Ren's a Skywalker,
right.
So...
See, and the problem is, I don't want either of those. I don't... That is the only problem.
Who else can it be? I mean, Luke's dead, so...
Well, like,
Anakin's
Leia's
gone.
Leia's a Skywalker.
Yeah.
Leia's a... That's what... I mean, but they can't do anything with Leia.
Yeah, not really.
Yeah.
I was saying that I kind of hope that because Luke went out as this sort of legendary figure... sacrificing himself to save the resistance, that the word Skywalker will kind of become synonymous with like hero or legend, and that will be something that Rey winds up being called, like that she's not actually related to him, but that she gets called a Skywalker because it kind of becomes a phrase synonymous with heroism. And I'd be okay with that being the reason for the title, that Skywalker becomes sort of a nickname for an altruistic hero, which I think would be cool.
Sounds a little out there, but I don't know. Possibly.
Wait. Oh, my senior design team. Oh, is my senior design team listening to this? That's cool. The showrunners of Game of Thrones.
Give them a shout out.
Yeah, they said shout us out. They say the showrunners of Game of Thrones are going to make a trilogy, and it's going to be amazing. Wait, a trilogy of Star Wars movies? What?
No.
Or a Game of Thrones Game trilogy. Game of Thrones.
Well, no, because then he says a Star Wars trilogy.
Oh, man.
Like, okay, wait. Now I'm confused. So those showrunners are getting a trilogy? So Lucasfilm isn't stepping back. What? Oh, yes, he confirms.
Yeah, okay, that's cool. Interesting. What?
Apparently the showrunners of Game of Thrones source Brian from my senior design project is the showrunners of Game of Thrones are going to be making a Star Wars trilogy. Cool?
That's
neat.
Yeah.
They are, but in the future. Is it set in the future? Or does that mean they're going to make it in the future? You got to give me more details than that, Brian.
Yeah.
But yeah, okay, cool. That's exciting. Does anyone watch Game of Thrones here?
No.
None of us. I love that we have a pop culture discussion podcast the day after Game of Thrones comes back, yeah. And none of us have anything to say.
Yeah. No, the only HBO show I've ever seen was the first season of Westworld. And I liked parts of it, but I felt like there was way too much. There was not enough plot. And way too much like action and gore and overly sexualized scenes.
That's true. Westworld was interesting. I haven't seen all of it. I've seen parts of it. And
wait,
my...
you didn't? Oh gosh. Okay.
What?
I can't say anything then because the season finale of season one is a total mind fuck. It's like
okay, cool.
Wait, can I say that?
No, you can't.
Oh shoot.
And so.
Oh no.
Basically. Yeah, my dad told me a whole bunch. My dad watches Westworld. He thinks it's great. I don't know.
The plot is really cool.
I've been sent an important news update article.
Oh, okay,
we've got information now.
Whoa.
The Game of Thrones showrunners are writing a new Star Wars film series. Interesting. Lucasfilm has already announced that The Last Jedi writer-director Rian Johnson will be creating his own Star Wars trilogy. When was this article? Oh, February 6th. So, okay. So maybe this is still true.
We'll see.
That would be cool if it's still true. I don't know. The most recent thing I've heard is that nothing is going to happen for a while and that they're going to take a step back. But maybe they're planning something big and they're just not telling us yet. We know that Marvel likes to do that.
Yeah.
We know Marvel likes to do that a lot. Marvel creates entire fake trailers just to prevent you from guessing what's going on in their movies, apparently. The Russo brothers confirmed that like everything you see in the trailers is from the first 20 minutes of the film, but also some of the stuff in the trailers just isn't in the film at all, and they deliberately put it in there just to make you think something that's not going to happen.
Really?
Yeah.
If you look over the Infinity War trailer, you see Hulk running with them at Wakanda.
Yeah,
and
that Hulk
never happens.
Nope, not at all. And there were even like toys of like Hulk bursting out of the Hulkbuster, which never happened in the movie.
Yeah.
So they're really good at faking people
out. They even made
a pop out
of that.
I'm impressed by the Russo brothers at this point. They were in an interview recently where in one of the recent trailers, we see Tony and Cap shake hands and it's, you know, do you trust me? And he goes, I do. And they shake hands. And the guy interviewing them was like, that's such an awesome moment. I know you can't say much about it, but could you tell me what it felt like, you know, like putting, you know, writing that scene? And then one of them goes, oh, that scene's not in the movie. We just kind of...
What
are you doing?
What?
Oh my God.
And so you never know with the Russo brothers. They are tricky.
That's coming out next week, right?
Next week.
No,
like,
not this.
Endgame?
Like
it's
next.
On,
it's coming out next week.
Yeah, you're right. Next Thursday.
Yeah.
Not, yeah, hey. I'm
not
losing track
Thursday,
of time, man. I'm losing track
you're
of time.
Losing track of time.
Speaking
you're
of
just
like
dumb.
Yes and
yes and first rule of improv.
Excuse me.
I mean, this whole radio show is basically improv, so
it is. Yeah. It's just
well,
it's
I mean,
just
not
people
just the radio show.
Rambling.
Life in general is just improv.
If you know what you're doing in life, you're doing
you
something wrong.
You say this as an actor. It's like
I don't think anyone knows.
There are things you do that are literally scripted, so it's not true for life all the time.
No, life's always improv. What in life is scripted?
When you're performing a script.
But
that's what I just said.
That's still improv.
That's like the only time you're
when
not
you do
improv-ing.
It right, it's not improv.
Is ironically
and not.
Is ironically when you are playing to the analogy.
Oh, yeah. Also, if anyone's listening, if they made it this far, come see the Texas Review.
Oh, you can't do that.
Yeah, I can.
You can't say that.
Yeah, I can.
No, you can't.
Yeah, I can.
No, you can't.
Yeah, I can.
No, you can't.
Yeah, I can.
All right, fine. We'll just do this for the next 5 minutes.
All right.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
But yes, Arjan and I will be hosting the Texas Review, and we will be tabling at some point in the next 2 weeks for like 3 hours to yell at people on Speedway about how badly we want them to come see the Texas Review.
Are we
really
going to yell at them?
Yeah, we're going to yell at. That's how tabling works. You yell at people.
Whoever yells the loudest.
You got to be good at it.
We can't like yell at them because then we're going to.
You're going to be outside.
We're going to intimidate them. Ah, well,
you have to project.
Diaphragm. Diaphragm.
Say that. Don't say we're going to yell at them. Say we're going to project at them.
We are going to project at them with our diaphragms.
There we go.
Okay.
Most people won't know what that means, though, and they're going to think it's like some sort of weird astral projection. Or you're going to get a
you know
projector
what?
From the classroom.
You know, maybe we should figure out how to do that. I will astral project onto people.
I mean, that'd certainly get their attention.
My intention for them to come see the show.
All I need is a projector, and I can already do that.
An astral projection.
But you'll have to get an outlet,
spirit.
And there's not many of those outside.
I'm going to...
Really long extension cord, yeah.
Really long
extension
cord.
I suppose. That just sounds unwieldy.
Or a portable charger.
Ooh, a portable charger.
One powerful
for
enough for a projector?
Or a generator?
Oh, you'd be surprised. There's a
but
lot
see,
of portable chargers.
We're
going to
be doing this in the
I think
middle
at that
of
point
the
you're
day.
Getting...
Portable projectors.
I think
yeah.
you would
they
just
have those now.
Rather get a generator, no. not a, char- a
Generators
portable
are too big.
How do we even wind up arguing about these kinds of things on this show? It blows
because
my mind.
Because somebody brought up something that they're not supposed to.
Well, someone said something they're not supposed to.
Uh-huh.
That was an accident, and I
well,
wasn't
an accident
entirely...
too. So my accidents are not invalidated.
Uh-huh.
People make mistakes. That's the real lesson to be learned this hour.
Don't come at me when you've done the same
people
thing.
People make mistakes.
So...
One of mine was creating this show.
And you didn't even create it.
You
sure
I didn't.
Don't
well,
take credit. That's not yours.
Okay, I didn't create the show, but I fundamentally changed
no, you didn't.
What it was. Yeah, I did.
Okay, you,
it wasn't
you,
supposed
yeah.
to be a pop culture discussion show when it started. I just got bored of the intended topic,
mm-hmm.
Which I don't even know how to describe anymore. But yeah, so we're hosting the Texas Review. That's going to be fun. That is UT's largest student-run talent show. 10 acts get selected.
11.
It's going to be... Oh, 11 acts.
Well,
okay.
No, 12. I looked at the talent.
Is that counting the exhibition, I guess?
I guess. I looked at the talent sheet, and it's 12.
Okay. And so we will be going to, when is it? It's the 27th?
April 27th.
April 27th at 7 p.m. at the Hogg Auditorium. That's where we're going to be that night, so that'll be cool. I'm excited. Yeah. I think you're excited. You accuse me of being overly excited about everything, so clearly I can't tell what's supposed to be exciting, but I'm excited about that.
Excited.
I didn't even know
everything.
About it until
yes,
now, but I'm going to come.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to come as well. So.
That should be fun. So, we've talked about Star Wars. We've talked about Marvel. We've talked about...
Yeah, that kind of rhymed.
Random... Wait, did it?
No.
What?
This is why you're bad at rapping.
Star Wars, Marvel.
No.
Wars. That's not even a slant rhyme.
Wars,
oh my God.
Vol, it's practically the same word.
Yeah, it's practically... And you've never even heard me, so you can't...
Mar-Wars. Jordan has sent me Snapchats on multiple occasions.
I do Snapchat
That's
your rap sometimes.
I'm not trying. I never
See,
try
I'm telling
when
you,
I
we gotta like find, we gotta do that bromance song.
Yes,
no.
do, it.
Do it.
Do
yeah.
it.
Yeah, I'll sing.
It's
you
such
can
a
rap.
Good song.
We'll make a music video for Chester C's bromance.
No.
From like 6 years ago.
No.
That was a jam.
No.
That was a good song.
He is still posting stuff, by the way. I looked on his channel.
Oh, really?
And he posted something a month ago.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, and then something 3 months ago.
I gotta go watch some of his videos then. Because I haven't seen any in a very long time. That got abstract really fast.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Endgame. Gonna be cool.
Yeah.
So excited.
That's the gist there. We're about out of time. Anyone have any random closing remarks on, like, pop culture?
Kinda, yeah. It has really nothing to do with any... Sort of.
Go for
okay.
it.
Okay. It's just a little rant. Okay, so the MCU takes place in the same timeline as like us, right? It's not like 20 years in the future. It's right now, right? In Black Panther, Shuri, she references the "What are those, Vine?" right? Mm-hmm. Which means that Vine is in the MCU, right? You know where I'm going with this, right?
I don't, but I'm excited.
Okay, so It Is Wednesday, my dudes, Vine, therefore it came out before Spider-Man was ever introduced into the MCU.
Oh,
therefore,
no.
Spider-Man's suit is based off of the It Is Wednesday, my dudes guy.
Aha! We've cracked the code and solved the ultimate conspiracy. And on that note, we'll talk to you next week. Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.